medium through which sound travels. When a vibrating object moves forward, it pushes and compresses the air in front of it, creating a region of high pressure. This region is called a compression. Now, this compression starts to move away from the vibrating object in all the directions. When the vibrating object moves backwards, it creates a region of low pressure called rarefaction. When an object moves back and forth rapidly, a series of compressions and rarefactions is created in the air. This makes up the sound wave that propagates through the medium. Now let's see a demonstration to figure out how all of this happens. For this, we will use a very unique object. It's called a slinky. Now let's hold it from both the ends. Now let's stretch the slinky and then give it a sharp push towards the other end. If we push and pull the slinky alternatively, what do you observe? You will observe that the slinky will move back and forth parallel to the direction of the disturbance. The regions where the coils come closer are called compressions, C, and the region where the coils are further apart is called rarefaction, R. The waves that travel in such a way are called longitudinal waves. In longitudinal waves, the individual particles of the medium move in a direction parallel to the direction of propagation of the disturbance. The particles do not move from one place to another, but they simply oscillate back and forth about their position of rest. Now, this is exactly how a sound wave propagates. So, sound waves are longitudinal waves. Well, it's been a great learning session till now, but it's going to